Hello everyone and welcome to our National Training Week session. I'm Adib and I'm delighted to be your host for today's sessions. We are honored to have our expert trainer, Ms. Samsia, who will be sharing valuable insight on boosting your productivity with Microsoft Excel formulas and functions. During the session, please feel free to ask questions in the chat box below. Ms. Samsia will address all questions at the end of the session. As a reminder, please keep your microphones muted throughout the session to avoid any disruptions. Without further ado, I hand over the floor to Ms. Samsia.
Thank you so much, Mr. Adik, for the introduction. Okay, Assalamualaikum semua. Good morning. Selamat pagi. Apa khabar semua pagi ni? How are you? Okay. Okay, welcome to our webinar. Let me share my screen. Okay, let me share my screen because we have only 1 hour session. So, Mr. Adib already introduced my name. So, I think without wasting our time, it's better for us straight away go for our session. Are you ready? Can you type yes in your meeting chat? Okay, great. Super. Thank you so much for your feedback. Definitely, class, I need two-way conversation. If let's say end of the day, you can ask me the questions, okay? And I need a response from y'all because I'm not able to see y'all face-to-face. But anyhow, don't worry. Inshallah, everything will be okay. Okay, let me share my screen. Okay, y'all able to see my screen, right? Okay, great. Now, I believe you all have downloaded the practice file. I have a copy and paste the link for you all to download. There is a three file actually. Okay, there is a three file. One will be the exact formula and function without any formula for us to practice now. And then there is one more file which I already named it as a complete. Okay, so end of the session, actually, if let's say you all miss some of the formulas, right? Don't worry, class. You will have the formula in another second file, okay? Which is you can find under Excel formula and function complete, okay? Ada dalam file ni, eh? So those yang tertinggal, yang tak dapat ikut saya, tak apa, jangan risau. You can find it in another second file lah, okay? Now for now, I need you to open the main file, Excel function and formula. Sorry, formula and function yang without the complete. Ini yang kosong. Okay, ini yang kosong eh. Okay. Okay, now, I believe class, most of you all here, some of you all may be familiar with Excel. Some of you all may be like zero knowledge in Excel or just came in to get an info on the what is formula and functions. Okay, so I'll bring through. Don't worry, those don't have the experience in Excel, don't have experience in your formula and function, right? You don't have to worry because I will start from the basic itself and then I'll bring through with the, some advanced formula that you can apply for your work, okay? So meanwhile, if you have any question, just stand by, put it in your meeting chat. Later on, after I finish up my session, I will go through the question from and answer for you all, okay? Boleh, eh? Okay, now, first, worksheet that you can see, class, there is a formula and fundamental. Ini pada yang very basics, okay? So, those yang ada dalam group kita ni yang familiar with the formula and function, take it as your revision. Okay, take it as your revision, eh? Now, formula, class, there is two things, eh? One is formula, another one is function. What is formula and what is function? Let me explain on that. Eh? Formula is like a very basic formula that we can add in your Excel. Like, biasalah, sometimes we add in our normal calculations, right? By using a calculator and so on, right? Also same thing. Okay, also same thing. It's a very basic one. So how basic one if we want to add in your Excel? Contoh, eh? When you want to start with the formula class, you have to remember, you have to start with the equal sign. You have to start with the equation. Now, I'm going to show you the example of formulas. Not a function, it's a formula. Eh? So, equal sign. When we start with the equation, as we know, we want to find a total. Kita nak cari jumlah. Betul tak, class? Kita nak carikan jumlah. Eh? So, bila kita nak carikan jumlah, kita akan ambil lah the cell. Cell, class, you don't have to go and key in like B2, C2, no. You can just click. Like how to click? Okay, straight away click on the B2. This is the cell name. Okay, this is the cell name. Eh? Pada yang tak ada info on the Excel, I will explain to you all also. Eh? So plus, campur. Eh? This is formula, not a function. Function later will come in. Eh? Campur dengan C2. And then plus video D2. Means sugar cookies. Eh? Okay, now once we put in this and we enter, you will get the answer 23. Okay, you will get the answer of 23. Same thing goes with this one. Okay, sama juga. Sama juga, you can drag down. Ataupun kelas, you can repeat again. Like example, equal B3 plus with your C3 and then plus with your D3 and also enter. Ini biasa kita buat dalam Excel. This is formula, standard. Eh? Function nanti saya datang. Maksudnya, di mana kita boleh gunakan sum. Sum comes under function, okay, where you can put in some arguments lah, eh? So that easy for you to come up with the proper analyze with your documents, okay, ataupun Excel kita ni lah. Okay, profit pula sama jugalah, equal, okay, revenue minus with your cost, minus with your cost. Now let's say we have this one. This is the first formula we already applied. We don't want to repeat again, right? What you can do, straight away class, you can drag. Macam mana kita nak drag? Letakkan cursor kamu, put your cursor on your right hand side. That is, you can see one small box there. Okay, yang warna hitam ni. And you can see your cursor change to plus sign. Plus sign yang warna hitam ni. Eh? So, you click and drag. Okay, that's how you get the formula. The formula will be copied. This is called as a relative reference. This is called as a relative reference, where Excel copied the formula when you drag down or when you drag the columns. Okay, when you drag down the row or when you drag the columns. Okay. Okay. Now, the next one. Next example. Eh? Next example. Now, let's say example, we have text here. Kita nak darab dengan text. So, as we know, profit darab dengan text. And this text rate, kita ada di mana? Di G. Dua. Tahu tak kelas? Yes or no? Can you type one in your meeting chat? Okay. Thank you, Vivian. So I can see your... Because I access to another laptop, so I can still see your comments there. Okay, now, example. Eh? Okay, let me delete off this. Example. So, we will start with the equal sign. Equal sign. B4 times with your... Times with your one option class, you can straight away put in 10%. You key in, means you key in like this 10%. That is the one first option. Second option class, you can click on your cell. That is G2. Okay, G2. Eh? So, I meant it. So, you will get 0.6. Okay, 0.6. But class, you see here, eh, when I drag, you will see I'm going to get a zero value. Zero value. So I believe you all also same with that. Am I correct or not? You're going to get a zero value. Yes? Type yes. Or you can type in number one. Okay, great. Thank you for the response. Okay, now, so means class, Excel didn't make any mistake. Actually, just follow the relative reference. Remember, I said when you drag, it's going to be a relative reference. Nothing wrong with the Excel. The thing is, our formula, there is an error. What we should do, class, kita kena lockkan cell. Macam mana kita nak lockkan cell? Iaitu kita kena lockkan the 10%. So, how to lock the 10%? Okay, example, eh? Just double click on your formula so that the formula is activate. Or you can press F2. Okay, short form dia adalah F2, eh? The function key of F2. So, once I click on the F2, you can see the G2, right? So, you can lock it. How to lock? You can press the F.
Sorry for disruption. Miss, I can hear you. I can't hear you.
Jadi, is it clear?
Okay, right now, okay.
Okay. Thank you, Jadi. Okay, let me come back again in class. Sorry for that. Okay. So this will be the formula, right? So as I said, you need to lock the cell. Need to lock the cell means you have to lock the G2. So how to lock the cell? You can use a dollar sign. So short form atau ataupun shortcut dia lah untuk dapatkan the dollar sign, you can use F4, function key F4. That you can see in your laptop, right, class? There is F1, F2, F3 until F12, right? That is a function key. Okay, depend on your laptop also, class. Some laptop straight away you can press the F4. Some laptop we have to press FN, means the function key together with the F4. Then you will get the dollar sign. The dollar sign means you're locking the row and also the column. Now you can press enter and you drag. So you get the answer. You can see in column C5, right? The cell is locked to G2. So function key, kalau ada yang terlepas, function key maksudnya yang ni, Fn dengan F4. Ha, ni function key. Ikut laptop masing-masing ya, kelas. Ikut laptop masing-masing. Some laptop F4 terus. Some laptop you have to press Fn and together with your F4. Okay? You all manage to get or not? Boleh tak tap number 2 dalam meeting chat, kelas? Okay, Alhamdulillah. So, I can see some replies there. Okay. This is very basic, eh? This is very basic. Now, let's say example. The profit. We want to split into two. Let's say example, we have two shareholders. So, we want to split into two. So, kalau dalam in your Excel, right? Divide. How to divide? We don't have the divide yang macam kita buat kat sekolah. Tak ada dia divide, eh? So, divide in the formula, the symbols, eh? So, how? Profit. Start with the equal sign. Don't forget, class. Start with the equal sign. 6 divide by, this is the divide, eh? Slash, eh? Divide by 2. Example. Okay, divide by 2. You akan dapat. 3 lah. Okay, sebab saya ambil yang profit di bawah, chocolate chip. Kalau lah saya ambil yang di bahagian, if let's say example like last, overall profit. Let's say example overall profit, the 14, eh? So I will get 7. This is a very basic formulas. Not a function yet, eh? This is formula. This is formula in your Excel. Okay? Okay. Now, next one. We go for the next one, eh? Now, next one, example class, I put in the tax rate in a different worksheet. Might be some of you all ask, can I have the tax rate in a different worksheet? Yes, you can. The format going to be same class as what we did here. It's just you have to go and choose the worksheet. So how to choose the worksheet? So I just put it here, down here. Equal. It's going to be equal. The same before. Okay, same before. Times with your. Go to the worksheet tax rate. Go to the worksheet tax rate. Okay. Click on the 10%. Okay, click on the 10% and enter. Then you will get the same thing. See, it's showing the worksheet name. It's showing the worksheet name. You all okay with that? Same thing, yeah? You just have to repeat the same thing. It's just the data is in a different worksheet. So it's on you. It's optional. Either you want to put it the rate in the same worksheet or different worksheets, eh? Okay, so I believe you're okay with the first intro. Okay, you're okay with the first intro. Now we move on with the order of operation. Order of operation in Excel. There is an order operation in Excel. You have to know before you move on to the advanced formulas. Okay, why I'm teaching this one, class, might, as I mentioned earlier, might be some of you are not familiar with formulas, right? At least you are clear with this. After this, when I go for some advanced formulas or very common formulas used in the market, means in the companies, at least you all will know what I'm talking about. Okay, if not, you'll be like missing out lah, eh? Okay, I don't want that to be happen, eh? Okay, now example here, profit. We have a tax here. We are looking for the tax. Same thing, profits done. So tax, same thing. Example, eh? Equal, let's say, eh? I put in revenue, okay, revenue minus with my cost. Let's say example, I'm not going to take profit, but from here. And times with my percentage, that would be my 10%. And I enter. So you can see, class, my tax is more than my profit. So something wrong there. So for Excel, what happened is, when you see this formula, right? What happened is, Excel will take B3 times with D2 first. For Excel, that is the order of operator. Sorry, operations, eh? Order of the operation. So you have to put in the parenthesis or the open and close bracket. So you give instruction to Excel. Okay, you do this one first. Okay, Excel minus up B2 and B3. Minus up B2 and B3. Then only you times with your D2. This is the instruction. You have to give it to Excel. Then only Excel will do the right formulas. And enter, you get the 0.6. Okay, you will get the 0.6. This is the order of operation. Encik Kamal, jangan masuk saya punya screen eh. Okay. Okay. It's okay, don't worry about that. Okay, now. Let us continue. So far, I really hope you're okay, class. If you're okay, can I have number 3 on your meeting chat? Tak apa, Encik Kamal. Don't worry. Okay, great. Alhamdulillah. Okay. Now, we move on for the next one, eh? We move on for the next one. Okay, basic and conditional for matrix. Okay, hope you all were clear with that, eh? Don't worry about this NA, because when once we key in the formula, right, you will get the formula on your right hand side. I purposely put in the formula text so that when we practice, the formula is there for your own notes, eh? But anyhow, if let's say you missed out class, you don't have to worry also. As I mentioned, you already have the completed file. So you can just have a look on the completed file later on after class, eh? And you can practice. Okay? Okay, now, here, some other functions. There is 14 functions here I'm going to teach you. Function, this comes under function. Functions means you put in some arguments. Okay? Now, remember just now, for the plus, okay, the first formula, we was putting in like a plus 1 by 1. If let's say you have a huge data, we are not going to do that. Definitely, we are not going to do that. So, comes in the formulas. You will use some formulas, functions. Okay, formulas in Excel, actually a lot, class. You can see on your tab here, above here, there is a ribbon. Okay, there is a ribbon. Ribbon means overall yang atas di, yang hijau tu lah. Okay, yang hijau ni, eh. This is name as a ribbon, eh. So, tab means this is a tab formula. So, in the tab formula, you can see there is a lot of formula, class. Definitely, we are not going to cover everything today. I'm not able to do that. But if you all have a chance, class, if let's say there is a class in the, especially for formula and function, like 2 days training or 1 day training, or sometimes we do provide like a 5 days training. Depends, okay? Depend on the customer request also. And depend on the, what is the outline is going to be, okay? So, if let's say there is some training like that is offered, go and enroll. Okay, go and enroll. Eh? So, we will give you all more detail on the, or more example on the formulas. But what I'm going to cover for you now is some of the formula that's very commonly used. Eh? Okay, now, for total up. Total up, just now we were trying the plus sign, right? Now, if let's say you're using functions, we will be using a formula with the sum. Okay, formula with the sum. Sum, actually, you can find under formula. This is the one, sum. You can use the formula here. Or another option, class, what you can do is, you can, let me zoom in a bit, eh? You can use equal sign, untuk jumlah, ingat ni, sum, total, okay, for total is a sum, so you can use a tab, you use a tab, once you click on the tab in your keyboard there, eh, you will get the open bracket. So, senang untuk kita lah. Tak payah nak key in the whole thing. Tak payah lah. So, you key in sum and then tab. Press the tab. You get the open bracket. And straight away, class, you can highlight the range. See? I just click and drag. I don't have to put in a plus sign 1 by 1. No. I just have to drag. Once drag, Excel will highlight the range. I don't have to worry about the range also. I don't have to remember about the cell name also. Excel will highlight for you. It will name it for you. You don't have to worry about that, eh? Now, once done, enter. You will get the 167. Now, you need the same formula to be placed, right? You need the same formula to be placed. So, how? You drag down. The same place, you drag down. Actually, there is an option, you double-click. But unfortunately, for this practice part, you cannot double-click, class. Why? We have some other fill-up form here, okay? We have to fill up some cell here, so you cannot double-click, okay? Okay, that's for the total. Now, see, in class, when I key in the data here, the formula here, you get as your notes on your right-hand side, right? Okay, so that's the reason I put it here. So, no need to worry. This will be filled up on automatically. Okay, now, for the average. Kita nak dapatkan average, Kita tak perlu campur satu-satu and bahagi tiga. That is a very general way we do. But here, no. We just have to start with the equal sign. You just have to start with the equal sign. Average. There is a formula average class. Okay, there is a formula average. Okay, you can double click or you can use tab. Eh? Highlight the range. Highlight the range. Close bracket or even class. If you forget to close bracket, don't worry. Excel will close bracket for you. Let's say purposely we didn't close bracket. Eh? Enter. Still get the answer. And you can see class is a closed bracket. It will close for you. Okay, you don't have to worry about that. Same thing class here. I need to track down. Okay. I really hope you're all okay with that. Eh? Okay. Can I have a number four? Just to double confirm with you all. Great. Alhamdulillah. Okay. So far you're still following my sessions. Eh? Okay. Now, down here, we need a grand total. Another option class, grand total. If let's say you don't want to key in manually, if you don't want to key in manually, what you can use is you can straight away click on the auto sum here. Click on the auto sum that you can find on the formula. Okay, auto sum. Excel will put in the formula for you, including the open bracket. Including the open bracket. And now when you enter class, you get the answer. That is the first location you can find the auto sum. Second option is you can go to home, this home, eh? Home, on your right hand side, there is a auto sum, this one, same thing. Either you go to the tab formula or you can go for the tab home, on your right hand side, you will find there is a auto sum, depend. Or you want to key in manually also, can, so on you. Okay, it's on you. So now I need the same thing to be applied on my right hand side for the columns, right? Straight away, what I can do, I click on the same button that the small icon there. Click and drag. Click and drag. So you get answer. Now you might be asking, I say, can I put up the dot point form, right? 556.666. So how to remove this? You can go format cell. If not class, you can use the decimal here. Okay, you can use the decimal here by clicking the cell. You can remove the decimal point. Where? It's under home. This one. Under home, you can find here. Either you can increase or you can decrease. Okay, it's optional. Okay. Okay. That is done. Eh? That is a very basic function. Okay, very basic function. Sum average. Okay, now we go for the next one. Okay, now, next one, I'm going to introduce for you conditional functions. Conditional function means you put in some criteria. Okay, we put in some criteria. Eh? Now, here, we want to find number of students. Number of students. So, number of marks. Eh? Number of students. So, if let's say you want to find number of students, there is few formulas you can use, class. That is will be like count. You can see on my notes here on your right-hand side. You can use count or you can use count A. The difference of count and count A, I'll explain to you all. Eh? Now, let's say I'm using count. Let's say, example, I'm using count. Eh? Equal count. You can use step and class. You can use step. Equal count. Open bracket. Now, just because I'm using count, I need to highlight the range that have numbers. I need to highlight the range that have numbers. Okay? Close bracket and enter. So I will get 10 of them. 10 of them. Now, let's say example. You might be asking me why I need to highlight the range of the numbers. If let's say I go and highlight the name, what happened? Okay, let's say example. I do it for you all. I highlight the name. Okay, I highlight the name. Okay, when I highlight the name and enter, what happened is class, I get 0. Why? Because count cannot read characters. It's only read numbers. Remember that, eh? Count, it's only read the numbers, not the character. Now, if let's say you still want to highlight the name, so how? You just have to change to put in and add in a A, count A. Once you put in a count A class, it will read for you the character and also the number. If let's say I change the range, right? Let's say I change to English. okay, I change to English and then enter. Still, I will get the answer. So it's on you. Either you want to use count or count A. Just remember, if let's say count A, you can highlight both range with name or the number. But just one thing, count cannot, eh? Only with the numbers. So now you know you have 10 of them. Okay, 10 of them. Now we want to find a number of subjects. Number of subjects. So for number of subjects, anyone can answer me in the meeting chat. Should I use count A? Should I use count? Which would be better? Anyone can answer me in the meeting chat? Count A. Wang, thank you, Wang. Okay, great. Count A. Eh? So why we count A equal count A? Thank you so much for the response because I need two-way conversation, definitely. Count A. So I'll be highlighting the range English to science. Only this. Okay. Then close bracket and enter. I will get three subjects. Number of subjects. This is how you use the count. Okay, this is how you can use the count. There is a count ifs, there is count blank. You can find blank cell by using a count blank. Okay, that one you can try and see. But count ifs later I will teach you also. Eh? Now here, down here. We want to find the maximum marks. Okay, maximum marks. Here comes the second, another formula, max. Another formula is max. To equal max means the total, the higher marks, eh? Paling tinggi. Maka yang paling tinggi, siapakah mereka? Ataupun siapa number, eh? Sorry, maafkan saya. The higher marks lah, eh? Siapa, jumlah paling tinggi lah. Eh? Open bracket and highlight the range. And close bracket and enter. I will get 89 is the highest. Who's the person? It's John. It's John. Okay, ni cara dia, eh? So now what I can do, I can drag until here, my total marks. My total marks. Okay, so I hope you're okay. Same thing class, minimum marks, markah paling rendah. Kita cari siapa ke markah yang paling rendah. Bukan siapa, eh. Markah yang paling rendah, eh. Equal minimum, M-I-N. Minimum. You can highlight the range. You can highlight the range. Close bracket. Or you can straight away enter. You will get 39. For the rest, you can drag until right hand side. Settle with this. Some of you might be scared not seeing the table is too much information that you have to put in, right? But I believe now you're all okay with that. Okay, it's not that difficult. It's just you have to know how to use it, the formula class. Understand how to use the formulas also. And when you can use it, that's it. Okay, Excel formulas, actually, if you ask me, it's not very tough. You just have to practice it. Lah, eh? Practice it. Okay, number of students. Okay, now the next information that we are looking for. Number of students that get more than 60 marks. Okay, number of students that get more than 60 marks. Now, here we have some criteria. We are looking for number of students that have more than 60 marks. Okay, more than 60 marks. Okay, you can use class count if. Count if means it comes with the criteria. Because you are looking for more than 60 marks, right? So, in English, we want to find number of students. How many of them get the 60 marks? We are not going to calculate manually one by one. This is then okay lah. Still okay for you to calculate. Tapi kalau dah kita ada 100 pelajar, takkan kita nak kira-kira satu-satu kan? We won't do that, right? So, macam mana? So, you can use the count if let's say there is a criteria. Remember that, right? So, highlight the range. This is the range. Comma. The criteria, put in a code, okay, quotation, eh? Code, more than or equal 60. If you want to include 60, make sure you put in equal sign. Make sure you put in the equal sign. If let's say you didn't put in the 60 right class, what happened is, even though I have a 60 in my marks here, it will not include because I'm looking more than 60, not including 60. So I close code. In close bracket and enter. I will get four of them. One, two, three, four. Four of them. Okay, four of them. Okay. Now, the same thing, if you want to apply for the rest, you can straight away check. Because it's going to be relative reference. You don't have to worry. Excel will highlight the range. It's a relative reference, nothing to be locked. You don't have to lock any of the cell. It's going to be say followed by the relative reference. Okay, you don't have to lock the cell. So you will get 4, 5, and 4 again. Okay, now next one. Next one, now I want to find number of student fail. Means less than 60. Okay, less than 60. Same thing, class, you can use count if. Count if the range will be my English. Okay, English, eh? Sama juga class, comma. And then code, less than. Less than, eh? Here, I'm not going to use the equal sign. Sebab saya nak kurang daripada 60. Less than 60. So, saya letakkan 60. Code, close code, eh? And close bracket. Close bracket. And enter. Now, you get the 6 of them. So, you can see, even manually kita kira, 6 campur 4 dengan 4, 10. So, you, nothing wrong with that. Okay, betul lah formula kita. Okay, betul lah formula kita. That's why I say, you have to know where to use, when to use. Okay? Then you akan, you find this Excel formula not that difficult to use. Cuma kita kena faham konsep dia lah. Another thing, class, actually, the instruction is already given down there. So, bila kita masukkan formula. Okay? You just have to follow the formula, the instruction. Another one more location is this one. The insert function. Insert function pun boleh. You can use insert function. You can use insert function. When you click on the insert function here, actually in Excel, they will give some instruction. What you have to put in, what is next, what is next. Easy for you to follow lah. Okay. If you want to use the insert function pun boleh. Ataupun key in secara manual macam saya pun boleh. Okay. Now next one. Total marks of student. Eh? Total marks of the student. Okay, now total marks, sorry, total marks of the student more than 60 marks in maths. Kita nak cari dalam maths. Total marks of the student, eh? Jumlah. So, equal jumlah markah. There is a criteria. When there is a criteria, as I said, if will come in. You akan includekan if. So, bila ada jumlah, we know is sum. Bila ada criteria, kita tahu is if. So, kamu masukkan sum if. Actually, if dia ada banyak. There is a sum if, there is an average if. There is a count if, like just now we tried. Okay, now dia tanya range kan? Range kita disebabkan maths class. Kita nak cari maths eh. Jumlah markah dalam maths eh. So, you highlight the range. Inilah range. Okay, that's going to be a range eh. Comma. So, it's asking you the criteria, right? The next one is criteria. As we know, the criteria is going to be more than or equals to 60. Don't forget the quote, open quote, eh? More than or equals to 60. Close quote again, close bracket again, and enter. You will get 334. Betul ke tak? Nak cuba check? Boleh. You just have to use the control button. This is the first one, as we can see, for Tom. And then for John. Lim, Morgan, and City. 3-4. And even class, you can check on your status bar down here. Ni adalah status bar kita. You akan dapat 3-4. Sama saja. Okay? That's how you double confirm whether your answer is correct or not. Okay? Your answer is correct or not. Eh? Okay, now, next one. Number of students more than 60 marks in all the subjects. Number of students, more than 60 marks in all the subjects. So, you are asking Excel, go and check individually in all the subject. Means in your Excel, in your maths, in your science. Then only you will calculate the total marks. Okay, you will calculate the total marks. Now, example, Ellen. Ellen cannot be included in. Why? Because English and maths is not more than 60. Like example, Tom. Yes, I can include in Tom. I can include in Tom. And then another person is will be like John. Okay. This is manually if let's say we go and find. But we are not going to find manually. Eh? Don't do that. Class. We have formula for that. We have formula for that. Just start with the equal sign. This is more than one criteria. You can use with the count if. Sorry, class. Count if. But you go for S. Count if. S di belakang. Sebab yang ni ada lebih daripada satu kriteria. Kita nak minta dia kirakan untuk English, Maths and Science kan? So, you have to go into the more than one criteria means you have to put in the S there. Okay, now it will ask you the criteria range one. The first range will be my English. So I have to highlight the English. Highlight the English. Comma. The range, sorry, the criteria for number one is what? Code more than or equals to 60. Close quote again. Comma. That is the first one. So you ask Excel, go and check in C4 until C13, is it more than or equals to 60 or not? Okay, this is okay. Keep in the memory. Comma. We go for the second criteria. Highlight the range. Highlight the range. D4 until D13. Comma. What is the criteria? It's going to be same. So code, open code, eh? More than or equals to 60. Close code. Comma again, because I have one last more. One last for my signs. Okay? So I let the range. Same thing. Excel going for the E4 and the E30. Comma. The criteria will be code, open code, eh? More than or equals to 60. Code again. And last one is close bracket. Last one is close bracket. So what happened, class? You try to understand the formulas, eh? We ask Excel, go to C4 until C13. Okay. Find out who is 60. Who get more than 60. Keep in the memory first. And then go and check in my D4 until D13. That's my maths. Find also who is the 60, more than 60. Keep in the memory also. In the last one, we are asking Excel, go for the science. Okay, go for the science range. Eh? Find out also more than 60. So once you all three have been calculated, once you enter class, you get three of them. Three of them. Who are they? This is the one. Tom, John, and also Lim. And also Lim. So far, y'all okay? Can I have number 5 in your meeting chat? Thank you so much for the reply. Alhamdulillah. Okay. Now, next one. Next one, eh? Total marks of the student that get more than 60 marks in all the subjects. In all the subjects. Now, this is for total marks. It's not number of students. It's a total marks. When it comes to the total marks, you can use the range, this range, total mark. And this total mark range class, actually, I already name it. I already name it. As you can see, when I highlight on your name box, where is name box? This is the name box. On your left-hand side, below the ribbon, this is name box. It's name as a total. I already name it as a total, eh? Okay. Now, okay, equal, you can use the, sorry, class, equal, sum if, because we have more than one criteria, so you use the ifs, S di belakang, more than one criteria, okay? Okay, now highlight the range. It will ask you the sum range, right? Sum range, straight away we highlight the total. Or you can key in total also boleh. That's why you get the name of total, eh? Sebab kita dah highlightkan range. Kalau kita tak namakan range class, apa yang akan keluar? F11 sampai lah F13. Itu adalah standard sebelum kita namakan cell kita. Sebelum kita namakan cell kita. Okay, now criteria range. So the first criteria range, eh? Okay, highlight the range English. It's going to be same, comma, open quote, more than or equals to 60. Okay, open quote, more than or equals to 60. Close quote again, comma. It's going to be repeat again, class. So you can straight away highlight the range, comma, open quote, more than or equals to 60. Open quote again. Comma. And the last one will be our this range. Comma, open quote, more than or equals to 60. open quote, close quote again, then close bracket. That's the last criteria. Okay, that should be the last criteria. So now when I enter, I will get 651. 651. Okay. So that's how you can use some of the formulas, eh? Or the functions comes under basic interconditional functions. There's one another two more last formulas that I want to share it with you all. Examples, eh? Okay, let's say example class based on our English. Okay, let's say like in our English range of English, eh? We want to find out top two, okay, or who's in the rank number two, okay, higher marks, second higher marks, lah, eh? Or we can say second higher marks. It depends. You want to find fifth higher marks or the top five or something like a top 10, you can use this formula. It's a new formula, okay, equal. You can you have this formula in 365, okay, you can find it in Office 365, eh? Equal large. Large, eh? Large. It will ask you the array. The array we are looking for, English, right? So highlight the range of English. Highlight the range of English, comma. The K means class switch rank. It means, like example, we want the second high marks, right? So you put in second, two. If you are looking third, you go put in the third, three. Okay, number three, tiga lah. Eh? So saya nak yang kedua, paling tinggi kedua. So, saya letaklah dua. Close bracket and enter. Saya akan dapat 78. 78 is the second. Ini. So, ini yang paling tinggi 89 kan? So, yang kedua adalah 78. Itu cara kita gunakan the formula of large. How you can use large? Kalau kita nak cari paling tinggi 5. Kalau 5, kamu letaklah 5. You just have to put in 5 here. Let's say example. Eh? You put in 5. So, you will show it to me. 5 will be 45. Okay. So, I just put it back again. 2. And enter. Sama juga less 2. Bawah 2. If let's say I want to find bawah 2. Equal eh. Jangan letakkan perkataan less pula. Salah. Small. Small eh. Equal small. Open bracket. Some of them I never use these formulas eh. Ini pun senang digunakan eh, kelas untuk you nak cari bawah 2, bawah 3, siapa, the amounts lah eh. Like example, you want to find like a sales eh, based on the sales below 3, the amount of the sales eh, you can use this. Comma, contoh eh, saya ambil 2 juga, bawah 2, close bracket and enter. You will get 45. Bawah 2 adalah 45. Sebab ni ada 3 kan, so dia ambil yang tu lah. You will take that one, eh? A lot. Ada 4. Sorry, maafkan saya. Ada 5. That is 5. Okay, so 45 yang adalah paling bawah kedua lah, eh? Okay, so I hope you all okay with this. So you can see the formula is already there. Okay, it's already there on your right hand side. Even though you can't follow just now class, don't worry. As I said, it's already in the completed file. You can check on the completed file. It's just one thing, class. I just want to remind you all again. You have to practice. Okay? You have to practice. Try it. Open the file again. Do it again. Inshallah, you'll be okay. Okay? Now, we move on to the next one. The text formula. A text formula. This one, why I put in the text formula? This is very commonly asked during the some sessions that I've conducted, right? So I just put in for you all also. So let's say example, you already have for some data from any other applications line, any other application, and you can see all in sentence case, means in lowercase. Everything is in a lowercase. You want to change to proper. Okay, how? Equal proper. This is a text. And enter. So you will get each of the letter, the characters eh, will be in a capital letter. Depan dia akan ada huruf besar lah. Ini untuk proper, formula proper. Now upper. Upper ni kita akan gunakan untuk huruf besar. Semuanya huruf besar. Semuanya akan jadi huruf besar. Okay, semuanya akan jadi huruf besar. Because class in Excel, there is no easy way untuk tukarkan this, change case eh. Tak boleh. Kalau word, can. So, equal upper, open bracket, equal apa, open bracket. I click on the cell, close bracket and then enter. So, I akan dapat semuanya huruf besar. You all manage to get class? I hope you all okay. Now, next one. Next one eh. Let's say example, kita ada dalam tiga separate cell. So, you want to combine it. You can use concatenate ataupun concatenate. Either one lah. Either one eh. Example lah. Click one eh. Concatenate. Let's say example lah. Concatenate. Text one will be my very. I can put in a comma. Okay, I can put in a comma. It's just because I need a space bar. Okay, space bar. So, I have to put in the quote. Open quote eh. Space bar. Close quote. And comma. So, this is going to be my text 2. This one going to be my text 2, eh? And then next one will be my text 3 will be my baking, comma, open quote again, space bar, close quote, comma, and last one will be my company. My company. So now when I close bracket and enter, I will get the Berry Baking Company together. Nah, ni caranya nak guna ni concatenate lah, eh? Okay, and then another one more option adalah menggunakan text join. This is another formula also. You can use text join. Text join, same thing. It will ask you what is the delimiter you want to use. Just now remember yang kita guna untuk concatenate kan? Kita buat satu-satu. Untuk ni tak perlu class. You just have to put in open quote, space bar, open a close quote again, comma, okay, comma eh, comma. This one just leave it. Ignore empty cell. You just have to highlight the range and enter. Okay, sorry, class. Okay. Sorry. One by one. Okay, this one, okay, empty, yeah, sorry, I forgot about the ignore empty, eh? This one you have to put in true, because we want to empty the, ignore the empty cells, eh? And comma, now you can choose this one, class. Now you can choose this one. Okay, close bracket and enter. So you will get this, okay? Make sure you have true, eh? Because we want to ignore any empty cells, eh? Okay, so that's how you can use the text join. That's how you can use the text join. There's few examples here. If let's say you want to use the text to column command. Text to column command, let's say example, and this is the example actually. If let's say you have a character something like this, you have a document like this, and you want to separate it. You want to separate it, you can use the text to column. Okay, you can use the text to column. Where to find the text to column? Let me delete off this. Okay. It's under data. Under data. There is a text to column. Let me click on the range first. Highlight the range. Data, text to column. Text to column, eh? There is a delimited. Next, I can see there is a dash, right? So I just put it here, other. That's my delimiter. Okay, that's my delimiter. You can see in your preview is already separate out. Next, okay. And then we can put in the destination. Destination, I can choose the cell of B19. And next again, until I finish it. So it will separate out. It will separate out. Okay, that comes under text function. Text function. So I hope you're clear with that. Now, few more to go. Okay. Logical functions. Okay. Let me finish up this. Logical function. Logical function class. If let's say there is a criteria, like example here, we put in a criteria more than, if let's say I have a table here, more than, let's say example, more than 70, I need a pass to be there. Less than that will be fail. Less than will be fail. So there is a criteria. As we know, we can start with the if function. This is with the if function. Okay, start with the equal. If, so you ask Excel, go to B10. Go to B10, the criteria. That is the logical test. The question mark you ask to Excel, eh? More than or equals to Is it 70? You ask Excel, so, yes, Excel, go to B10, is it more than or equals to 70? Kalau ya, this is done, eh? The logical test is done. Kalau ya, the value is true, eh? The value is true, as we can see in our table, we need to put in a plus. So, when you put in a text class, remember forever also, this is going to be same. You have to put in an open quote, pass, close quote, that is for the characters, eh? Comma, open quote again, fail, and close quote again. Okay, ini sekiranya fail. Sorry, sekiranya false, eh? Sekiranya false. So, it depends either, let's say, true, kita letakkan pass. Kalaulah salah, maksudnya bawah daripada 70 lah. Bawah daripada 70, dia akan fail. Close bracket and enter, you get pass. So, if let's say for down here, you can try to double click lah. Same place here. Now, you can try to double click. Dia akan drag down. Kalau ada data yang banyakkan kelas, dia akan drag down ke bawah terus lah. Dia akan drag down ke bawah terus. Okay. That's how you can use this double click. Okay. Shortcut lah. Eh? That's if let's say comes with the one if function. Okay. With one if function. So for you all, okay? Can I have number 6 in your meeting chat? Okay. Great, guys. Alhamdulillah. Okay, next one. Next one, if let's say you have more than one criteria. Here, senanglah, satu criteria je. Kalau kita ada lebih daripada satu criteria, maksudnya yang ni lah. More than 80, A. Kalau bawah daripada 80 ataupun di antara 50 dengan 79, B. Less than 50 will be fail, right? Okay, macam mana kita nak buat? Sama je. Cumanya, macam ni je, guys. Equal, if, open bracket, logical test, right? This is your marks, B24. Okay, B24, eh? Is it more than or equals to 80? That is the first criteria. Ask Excel, go to B24. Is it more than or equals to 80? If yes, as we know, code, don't forget the code, eh? As we know, it's going to be A. Kalau lah, ya. Kalau ya. That is the value if true, eh? Close code. Kalau lah, salah. Kalau salah, value if false, eh? Excel have to go back to B24. Excel have to go back to B24 to check is it more than or equals to 50 or not. If let's say, so if let's say you're asking Excel go back to B24, what do you have to do? You start again with if. Start again with if. This is called as nested if. Nested if. Okay, this is called as nested if. So if let's say kalau tak boleh click tak apa kelas, we key in ni lah. B24. B24, is it more than or equals to 50? If let's say this value is true, code jangan lupa eh, open and close code eh, equals to B. Kalaulah salah, there is no more criteria, unless the class there is continue more criteria, then you have to go back to if again and again and again. Kalau tak ada, ini kita dah tahu last ally adalah fail. The last one is going to be fail, right? So you just put in open quote, failure, close quote, close bracket twice. Kenapa? Kamu ada dua open bracket. And you can see the color also class. Here black color, the last one black color. Yang ni warna merah, yang ni pun warna merah. Okay? Now you enter. InsyaAllah you will get the answer. Double click. You will get the answer. So let's say example. This is 95, right? Example, I changed to 49. So, dia akan dapat fail. Sebab bawah, 50. Bawah, 50. If let's say I change to 52. Dia dapat B. Ni caranya menggunakan logical functions. Logical function. I did teach you all earlier, count if, sum if, average if, right? So, this is the if sahaja. Only if. Okay, only if, eh? Okay. Okay, now I move on for the next one. I move on for the next one, eh? VLOOKUP. VLOOKUP adalah yang very commonly people like to use. Okay? I just put in one example here only, eh? Class, but kita punya timing gitu, eh? So, I just put in one example only. Actually, we have a VLOOKUP, we have HLOOKUP, we have XLOOKUP and so on. Okay? Kita ada tiga, eh? Even we have lookup saja pun ada juga. But, say, I just able to show it to you only the VLOOKUP here. Example class, this is your table. Katalah ni dalam database kita. Ataupun data kita. Your data can be in your same range ataupun same worksheet. Or you can put it in a different worksheet. Pun boleh. Okay. Now, some of y'all might be like to use the VLOOKUP. And y'all used to use like locking the cell by pressing the F4. Dollar sign tadi lah. Dollar sign. Another option class that you have, you give a name for the range. Senang lagi. Okay, I prefer to give a name to my range rather than I highlight the range and then I have to press the F4 and I have to come back to my cell. Okay, if let's say this range or this table is in my another worksheet, susah sikit lah. So, bagusnya bagi nama. So, how you want to give a name? Highlight je lah. You can highlight. Highlight the range eh. In your name box. Name box kat mana? Sebelah kiri kita. On your left hand side. Below the ribbon, this is your name box. You want to give a name. Let's say this is the, okay, customer. I just put in a name of customer. Customer. Customer and I enter. Customer and I enter. Okay? So this range is already named as a customer. This is customer. See? Saya tak perlu highlight dah. Bila saya click on the name box here, I go and find customer, dia akan highlight untuk saya. Lebih senang lah. Okay, this is the one of the method lah. Another one method, you can highlight the range and put in the F4 eh. Okay, now we want to find the customer profession. Kita nak cari customer profession. Nama saya dah letakkan. I'm looking for Ramesh, Ali and Lim. Example eh, Ramesh, Ali and Lim. So equal VLOOKUP, lookup value. Lookup value will be, we're asking Excel, go to before. So that's going to match with my table. This is what going to match with my table. So lookup value will be V4, comma, table array, right? Remember just now we named the range with the name of customer. That is your table array. So I put in customer. This is my customer. See, when I key in the word of customer, Excel automatically highlight the range. Lagi senang. Daripada kamu nak pergi highlight, manual, and F4. Tak payahlah. Kalau data ni ada dalam in another worksheet, susah sikit untuk kamu kelas. But kalaulah kamu used to it using the F4, then tak apalah. You just continue with that. Okay? So you have two options now. Either you give a name or you use the function keys at F4. Eh? Okay, now comma. Now, after you comma class, it will ask you the column index number. Column index number, what you're looking for? Customer profession, right? It's in column G. It's in column G. Cumanya class, in VLOOKUP, it's not going to read G. For VLOOKUP, it's going to read from the column that just now the range that you highlighted. So for VLOOKUP, sebenarnya dia akan baca E ni sebagai kolom satu, F sebagai kolom kedua, G ni sebagai kolom ketiga. So as we know, profession is going to be kolom ketiga. So I put in there tiga. Okay, I put in there tiga. Eh? So I put in there tiga. Now, then it will ask you approximate match ataupun exact match. Approximate match ataupun exact match. Just remember, sometimes ada yang menggunakan true, dia replacekan dengan satu. Ada yang menggunakan false ni, dia replacekan dengan zero. Ada yang diletak belakang ni satu, ataupun diletak kosong. Kosong maksudnya false. Kalau satu maksudnya true. Okay, maksudnya true eh. Okay, contoh kita nak exact match. Saya nak yang tepat. Kalau saya nak yang tepat, saya ambil yang exact match. So once I click on the exact false eh, yang exact match eh, and I enter, saya akan dapat the manager of sales. So Ramesh, betulkan manager of sales? Betul. Okay. So Excel akan find out untuk kita. Yang lain saya boleh double click. Senanglah untuk saya ke? Senang untuk saya. Ha, ni cara nak gunakan VLOOKUP. Remember that eh. V4 is the lookup value. Table array adalah table kita overall. Kalau kita nak cari kolom mana, depend. Satu ke dua ke tiga, kamu letakkan. Kalau kamu nak telefon number, kamu letaklah nombor dua. Dia keluar nombor telefon. Dia keluarlah nombor telefon eh. Ha, itu cara dia kelas. That's how the thing works eh. So now, I put in number three again. So I have the customer profession. Okay. That's how you can use the exact match. If let's say you want to use true. Kalau true, you can use some example like I've given here. Okay, quick one class. Equal, VLOOKUP. Example, eh? Lookup value before, I put in this one is a second example. Eh? VLOOKUP, okay, VLOOKUP. This is a cell, C17, eh? Comma. Table array. Just now remember we give a name. Here I didn't give a name, eh? So I go and highlight the range. Katala, I highlight the range. So this is the highlight the range. I have to lock it. How to lock? Remember I told you all the F4? Fn, F4, lock can dengan dollar sign. Ha, ini option yang kedua. Siapa yang biasa dengan ni boleh lah. Kalau tak awal-awalnya bagi nama. You can give a name, eh? Come on again. Now column index number, we need the grade, right? So the grade will be in column which grade class? Can you put it in the meeting chat? Is it column 1 or column 2? Column 1 or column 2? Thank you, Miss Anusha. It's column 2. So you put in 2. Comma. This is going to be range in between. So I'm going to take approximate match. Not exact match, but approximate match. True. Close bracket and enter. I will get the answer. Why I'm using approximate match? But ni di antara. Kosong hingga 54. 55 hingga 69. Unless I give a exact number 54, 55. Then okay. I can use the exact match. For this, I cannot use exact match. You need to use the approximate match. Ni bezanya di antara approximate match dengan exact match. Eh? Okay, one last example on this. Eh? Quick one, a class example. Ini kita guna exact match kan? Iaitu false, right? See, eh? See, eh, class. Okay, example. Sorry. Example, eh? This is Ramesh. Okay. Belakang dia, saya letakkan A. Belakang dia, saya letakkan A and I enter. Dia akan keluar, not available. Tak ada. Sebab apa saya ambil exact match? Sebab saya ambil exact match. Exact cannot find in my table. Tak jumpa lah. Ni bezanya di antara false and true, eh? Exact match and approximate match. So that comes under VLOOKUP. Now, I want to introduce some new formulas that are available. I'm not sure whether you all have been used or not. But let me show it to you all. A few more to go only, class. I really hope you all bear with me. A bit more. Sikitnya lagi. Okay. Now, example, class. There is a V stack and also H stack. V stack and also H stack. Di mana kita akan gunakan, eh? Example, this is a fresh food inventory for Penang. Sila dalam di negeri Penang, eh? So, kita ada sales ID, fruits ni berapa total sales keseluruhan mereka. Dan yang ni pula di Selangor. Table ini adalah di Selangor. Saya nak combinekan kedua-duanya. One option you might be saying to me, I can copy and paste. Betul lah, you can copy and paste. But there is another option, you can use a formula. So, when next time when there is a add-in bawah ni, dia akan automatically tukar kelas. Dia akan automatically update. So, how? Equal B stack. Yang ni kelas. B stack, eh? B stack. It will ask you the array. Array maksudnya which table. So, let's say example, eh? I select the range. This is the first array. Maksudnya table yang pertama. Comma. Dia akan tanya table yang kedua, kan? Ataupun array yang kedua. Okay, array yang kedua. Saya highlight yang kedua. Katalah ada lagi, you can continue. Okay, you can continue. Ini saya ada dua saja. Saya close bracket and enter. Saya akan dapat. Saya akan dapat. See? Dia akan combine. Ha, this is another way of using the formulas of a V stack. Kalau H stack, sebenarnya dia akan arrange on horizontal. Sama je, equal H stack, eh. Cuma ni dia horizontal lah. Macam ni, class. When I highlight here, comma, and highlight this range. Close bracket and enter. So, you'll be like this. Why I'm getting an A here? Because here no values. Tak ada. Unless saya pergi tambah, contoh, eh. Okay, this one because we already did, eh. Dia tak ada. Dia tak akan tunjukkan di bahagian sini, eh. Dia tak ada. Okay, dia tak ada. Okay, so this one just did it off. So that we have the notes there. Okay, now, down here. Another one more options, eh? The formula. Two column ataupun two row. Two column ataupun two row. Two col or two row. Okay, ni, the complete word is two column. Okay, sama jugalah. You can use it. How to use it? Equal. Equal. Two col. So, next class. Array. Array, I can highlight this one. Saya highlightkan kedua-duanya, eh. Close bracket and enter. So, you akan dapat combination of both. Pun boleh juga. Ni two call. Okay, two call, eh. Okay, lagi. Turuh. Turuh pula macam ni kelas. Equal. Equal. Turuh. So now by row lah. By row. Same thing. I'm going to highlight the same range. I'm to combining the Pening and Selangor lah. Dua-dua sekali lah. Saya combine kan. Close bracket and enter. Dia akan by row. Dia akan dapat by row. This is another formula that you can try to use it. We stack ataupun two call eh. You boleh cuba gunakan stack and two call function. And then this one. Okay. Yang ini pula. I can say as a new formulas also available. Yang kamu boleh gunakan untuk text split. Remember just now I said you can use text to column kan. Another one eh. Example eh. I just show it to you all in class. If let's say you're not able to follow, don't worry. You have the notes there. Split equals split text eh. It will ask you the text. This is my text. Okay, this is my text. Eh? So it will asking me the delimiter, right? Comma first. My delimiter is going to be my dash. So saya letakkan dash di situ. Sorry, open quote, dash, close quote, close bracket, and enter. Saya akan dapatkannya. For the rest, I can drag down. For the rest, I can drag down. Don't worry, class. The notes is already in my another practice file. So, you can get that. You can use the text split, eh? Okay. And then another one more example. Let's say, class, you want to extract only the ID. You want to extract only the ID. Some of you all might have been using the formula of left or right. But here, there is another one you can use, class. Ini lebih baik. Ataupun lebih senang untuk kita nak cari, eh? Text before. Text before, eh? It will ask you the text, right? This is your text. So the delimiter, comma, it will ask you the delimiter. Delimiter after my ID is the dash. Yang tengah-tengah tu kan? Yang dash tu, eh? So saya ambil quote, open quote, dash, close quote, and close bracket terus. And enter. So I will get that sales ID there. Ni cara nak gunakan text before. Kalau text ID, you can use it. Let's say I want to take the sales. Yang 30,000, 32,000 kan? You can use equal text after open bracket. This is the text. Comma. Inverted comma. Same thing. Before that is what? After tu kan dia ada underscore kan? Kita ambil underscore. Close quote. Close bracket. And enter. So you will get the total sales. So, you get the total sales. So, yang ni kita boleh lah just tukarkan kepada RM ke ataupun you want to change it to accounting and so on. Boleh tukarkannya eh. Okay. So, that comes under text function. So far, you all okay? Boleh letakkan nombor 7 dekat meeting chat class? I'm really sorry. I'm taking a bit time of you all. Hope you all okay with that. Okay. Alhamdulillah. Thank you so much for the response. Okay. Two more class. Dua saja. You okay ke? Masih boleh ke? Masih boleh bertahan? Say yes. Sikit je lagi. Yes eh? Alhamdulillah. Thank you so much. Thank you class. Thank you. Okay. Two more formulas eh. This one also I will say it's a new and jarang orang gunakan. But maybe you all can try lah eh. Image. How to insert an image in yourself. Normally, selalunya kan kelas kita will insert picture, right? Insert picture and then you put in some pictures there lah. But here, I want to insert in my cell. Macam mana kita nak insertkan dalam cell? To insert in your cell kelas, there is a formula image. Okay, there is a formula image eh. Equal image. Contoh ni eh. Image eh. Don't worry about the enable content. Leave it first eh. So, it will ask you the source. Mana sos kita? Sos kita ni contoh eh. Contoh. Example eh class. Example. Example, I want to find. Just now it's Apple, right? Okay. Apple. So I need to search Apple in my this image. Let's see, this is the image. Okay, this is the image. Okay, when I right click on the image, right, you will see there is an option copy image address, not the image, eh? Copy image address. So now from here, go back to your Excel. I already copied the address, eh? Go back to your Excel. Equal image. So I put in the before that class, you have to have the open code, eh? Sorry, class. Paste the address that you copy, close code, okay, close code, close bracket, and enter. So you will get the image. Actually, you will get the image. It's just maybe that image with the copywriting you will not able to open. Let me try with this. Can I get this or not? Copy image address. Go back to my Excel. Let me try again. Eh? Sometimes some images cannot be copied because there is a copyright. Hopefully this works. Ha, see, show me the apple. This is how you get the apple. Okay, you will get the apple. Same thing class you can do for the banana. You just have to find the image of the banana and then you letakkan lah. Okay, so far you okay? Boleh ya? Cik, Alisa say, wow, canggih kan? Show me kan? One last example lah. Class, I give it to you for the banana. Tak terfikir kita nak buat benda ni kan? This is a new things class. Now, let me go and find banana for you. One last example class. Just hold on with me eh. Banana. Interesting. Okay, this is banana. Okay, so if let's say you're doing some report based on your products, right? And that product is only in your website, the pictures lah, eh? So you can use it like this. Cumanya we cannot resize, eh? Equal image, maafkan saya, equal image, open bracket, eh? Inverted comma, inverted comma pula, sorry, inverted code, sorry, open code, sorry, 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 open code, paste the URL, close code, close code, eh? Close bracket and enter. Ha, banana is there. Okay. So, inshallah, I hope you all have time to go and practice for the rest, eh? Okay, now, one last last thing that I want to teach you. Last one, eh, for today's session. Okay, this one. Let's say class, example. Example, this is the outcome. This is how the result is going to look like. Let's say example class, you have your data. You have your data in picture. In picture, that comes under by using a table like here. One example I have here, fruit table, eh? List of the fruits. Lah. But it's a picture, it's a JPEG. This one, eh? So I want to get this image to put in my Excel. I need this to be in my Excel. If I need this to be in my Excel, I don't want to key in manually. Takkanlah kita nak key in kan? Kalau sikit, tak apa. If let's say you have a lot, you don't have to do that. Okay, you don't have to do that. How? Okay, come with it, you all, eh? Okay. You can find under 365. Okay, Microsoft 365 ada benda ni, eh? So, siapa yang masih gunakan yang lama like 2016 and so on, you can, once you upgrade, right? Nanti kamu cubalah, insyaAllah, eh? Okay, you can find under data, under data, under data, you will find there is a from picture. From picture, if you copy that picture, right? You will come under picture picture from clipboard. Boleh juga. Kalau you copy tadi. Kalau kita tak copy, tak apalah. You go and find that file. Eh? How? From picture. Picture from file. Picture from file. Okay, just wait first. Where is my this one? My desktop. So my desktop. Maybe now. Okay, fruit table. Okay. And insert. You can see on your right-hand side, it will open for you the data from picture. It's a very good tool, you know, class. Because sometimes we receive a like a PDF file, but that data is already in the PDF file. You can use snipping tools, crop it as a picture first. And then you put it in your Excel like this. Okay? Now, it will ask you insert data. Click on your insert data. You responsible? Yes, just insert data. This is your data. This is how you get the data just now. So what you can do, this part, I can just delete it off. Left. Interesting, right? Then you can arrange it lah, as you all know, right? I believe you all familiar with this, putting in the borders and this one, you can merge it. If you all want some coloring, put in some coloring and so on. So that's how the thing works. This comes under image to table, where you can find under data from picture. Actually, it's already in your notes also, in your another practice file. The one that's completed, right? I already put in all the formulas plus the screenshot. So you can see from the screenshot. Okay? So I really hope you're okay with the lesson. Let me check on your comments. Is there any question, class? Alicia said ada mata dia bintang eh. Interesting. Anusha said interesting. Thank you so much, Kala. Thank you so much. Any questions, class, before I hand over to our study? I'm really glad to see your response for your feedbacks. Really appreciate, class, for the feedbacks. I really hope that you all can practice it. Make sure, class, I know it's very short time, it's 1 hour session, but try to come into some other sessions that we have, eh? And then practice it, whatever I already shared with you. Without practicing, definitely, class, you takkan expert dalam Excel. One day you can be expert like me also. Cuma kamu kena mahirkan diri lah. Keep on doing it again and again. Okay? You'll be expert better than me, class, inshallah. Okay? Any questions? Google Sheet can use few function. Betul. Yes, Anusha. You cannot use Google Sheet, yes. Even not only Google Sheet, eh, like Google Word, like PowerPoint, right? Also same thing. They are the tools are limited. Cannot be used, eh? We still learned this 20 years ago. But here. Any question, class? If no question, then I think I will pass over to Mr. Adib. Thank you so much again. Mr. Adib, hand over back to you, Mr. Adib.
All right. Thank you, Ms. Samsia, for the excellent presentations. Okay, regarding for your certificates, we are pleased to inform you that your attendance has been recorded and your course status will be marked as completed after these sessions. You will receive your e-certificate through the NTW portal upon successful completion of the TEE assessment. The certificate can be generated from the applied course section of your individual profile. As for the video recording of this session, it will be available on our YouTube channel at Excel Academy Malaysia by tomorrow. Now, let me inform you about our upcoming training session. If you are interested in enrolling in one of these courses, please contact us. So, we have Microsoft Excel Intermediate and Advanced Level, Microsoft Power BI Advanced Dashboard Reporting, this confirmed training. Next. Microsoft Power Query Mastering Data Transformation, Microsoft Excel Data Analytics and Visualization, AI Tools for Content Creation and Marketing, ChatGPT and AI Tools Mastery, Enhancing Marketing, Communication and Productivity, Digital Marketing Masterclass, Digital Marketing Professional. Next. SEO and SEM, Search Engine Optimization and Search Engine Marketing, Social Media Marketing. CapCut for Video Marketing and Canva Design Bootcamp. Alright, thank you all for your participation and have a great day. Once again, thank you, Ms. Samsia.
Thank you, Mr. Arif, and thank you, class.